In this screencast, I'll show you a few tips for customizing your projects in YouTrack. Let's start with your project team. This list shows all of the users who were assigned a team role in your project. To add a user to your project team, just select a user or group from this list. When you add users to the team from this page, they are added to the list of assignees in your project automatically. The assignee is just one of many fields you can use to assign different values to issues in your project. When you create a project, YouTrack gives you a default set of fields to work with. This project uses a standard set of fields and values for issues in a software development project. If you want to track other types of issues in your project, feel free to add new fields, remove the fields you don't need, or replace a field with a field that is used in other projects. Basically, you can do whatever you want. Here at JetBrains, we have teams that use YouTrack for more than just developing software. We have different projects for office administration, business travel, product marketing, customer support, release management, documentation, graphic design, research, and sales, each using their own sets of custom fields. So go ahead, customize the fields in your projects. Let's break it down. Default fields and their sets of values are usually shared with other projects. Still, I can edit the properties of this field and change its behavior. These changes do not affect other projects that use this field. If I want to set the priority for issues in my project by myself, I can enable the option to store an empty value and set the empty value by default. What I can't do here is change the set of values for this field in all projects. Here you can see that the set of values is used in other projects, and I don't have permission to update all of them myself. What I can do is make an independent copy of the field. All of the warnings about permissions disappear. Now, I can edit the set of values for this field to use whatever I want. If you rename a field, this change is applied in all projects that use this field. Again, you can see I don't have permission to perform this action. What I'll do here is create a copy of the field and assign it a unique name. This replaces the field that is shared with other projects, but still uses the same set of shared values. The subsystem field is attached to my project by default, but does not use a shared set of values. To build the set of values for this field, I can add values manually and copy values from another field that stores the same type of data. I'm still working with an independent set of values, so I can customize the list of subsystems I want in my project. If I want to use the same set of values from another project that I manage as well, I can merge these two sets of values, then edit the set for both projects. When I add or rename values, change the color scheme, or reorder the values in the drop-down list, these changes are applied in both projects. So, now that you've customized all the fields in your project, pick the fields that are most important to your team and put them at the top of the list. This order determines how fields are shown in the issues list and which fields are visible on an Agile board. Another feature you can fully customize to suit your team is time tracking. When you enable time tracking in your project, you choose which fields you want to use to store estimations and spent time, and define your own work item types. This lets you create time reports that show a breakdown of spent time for each category of work in your project. With workflows, you not only customize how you work with issues in your project, but can implement your own business logic in YouTrack. Here, you can deactivate individual rules or detach entire workflows that you don't want to use in your project. You can attach and activate default and custom workflows, or even script and import your own. One last customization option you might want to check out are the notification templates. YouTrack can send notifications when updates are applied to issues either over email or to a Jabber client. These templates let you customize each message independently for notifications in your project. Here we have the email notification that is sent when a change is applied to an issue. The subject line of the message tells the user who subscribes to this notification which event took place, then shows the issue ID and summary. You can even select which issue is used to preview the message content. Down below, you see a list of components that are used in these templates. Let's open the reason component. This part of the message explains why the user received this notification. Here, I'll add a few instructions to tell users to follow this link to unsubscribe from this type of notification. And that's a quick look at how you can customize a project that's tailor-made for your team. Thanks for watching.